How would you extract data from a PDF that's full of text, tables, and images? Well, traditionally, you would have to do something like this. First, extract the words from the page with the OCR system. Then, you can use a layout detection model on page objects, like tables, paragraphs, titles, and so on. And then you need to go over a bunch of chunking methods to discover which one might be the best fit for your use case. Just after all of that, you'll be able to create and store the embeddings. This approach is actually very time-consuming, and each page can take more than 7 seconds to be processed. But it can work well if you're working with text-heavy documents, meaning that your PDFs don't have lots of different layouts, images, tables, and whatnot. On the other hand, that's not most of the use cases we face in the real world. Most of the data that we work with is very rich, and lots of context is lost when we try to use those types of PDFs into these types of standard retrieval pipelines. But what if instead we could use a vision language model to help us retrieve the most relevant document page, giving a text query? Well, that's exactly what ColPali does. ColPali stands for Contextualized Late Interaction Over Polygamma, Polygamma being a vision language model. And what it proposes is that instead of going through the entire pre-processing pipeline we saw earlier, ColPali allows us to generate contextualized multi-vector embeddings directly from the image of a page using a VLM or vision language model. This means that the entire data ingestion pipeline can be handled by the VLM without the need of any text extraction and considering all visual elements of the page as well as the layout. This is what it would look like behind the scenes. The input image is divided into a 32x32 grid, which results in 1024 patches. Each patch goes through multiple transformations to capture local and global context and is then represented by a 128-dimensional vector. When you send a text query, the system creates token-level embeddings representations for the query and hangs the most relevant pages using a similarity matrix, specifically MaxSim. MaxSim helps compute similarities between each query token in every document patch, selecting the maximum similarity for most efficient retrieval. This allows ColPali to capture more context, improving search results by leveraging both the structure of the document as well as the text, using a strategy similar to Cobert. You can also use strategies like binary quantization to save on storage and compute while speeding up search times because working with these large datasets can get quite heavy. Let's see how we can do that, and we're gonna use as inspiration a blog post I really enjoyed by Daniel Van Strien, where he uses Qdrant and ColPali to search through a UFO document dataset, and he shows the entire steps from indexing to searching. He also uses scalar quantization as a compression method, and we're gonna try to use this time binary quantization paired up with rescoring and oversampling to see if we can speed up our search time while also maintaining a good accuracy. So let's get started. Okay, so this is the notebook that we're gonna be using for this tutorial, and it starts out by basically giving an introduction to ColPali, but we've already seen most of what's here, so I'm just gonna jump that to the session setting up ColPali and Qdrant. If you do want to read through it, I'm going to leave the link to this notebook on the description so you don't have to worry about it and you can try this on your own as well. So in this session, getting started, we are setting up ColPali in Qdrant, basically downloading the libraries and importing it. Then we follow up to downloading the UFO document dataset. Let's take a look at one random image from this dataset just so we know what we're dealing with here. Basically, we can see that this is a very complex image, and there's a lot of aspects to it that are very hard to decode with a traditional retrieval system. But let's move on and start by connecting to Qdrant. Right here, I'm using a Qdrant Cloud cluster with these specific specs, but basically, you can also use it in the free tier, in memory, or in any local setup of your choice. We move forward, and for setting up ColPali, we're actually using a model fine-tuned on this specific UFO dataset, so we can improve the accuracy that we're going to get. We're also setting up the ColPali processor that we're going to use to encode our images and query vector. Later on, we are going to start configuring our quadrant collection in step 5. Here, we're setting the size vectors to 128, like we saw earlier. We're setting up binary quantization while storing the actual original vectors on disk so we can save on RAM, and also setting up our multi-vector config. Later on, we start uploading the vectors to Qdrant. Basically, it's a good practice to add a retry checkpoint here in case any exceptions occur during the indexing process. We're gonna be batch uploading our vectors to Qdrant, and you can increase or decrease the batch size depending on your GPU availability. Here, we can see that for each batch, we're processing and encoding the images using the ColPali processor. We're also preparing the points to insert it into Qdrant and uploading the points to Qdrant with this try accept mechanism. The next step here is processing the query. Basically, we're going to also process this query using the ColPali processor, and what we're going to get here is a tensor. So we're going to want to transform this tensor into a multivector so that it can be used in Qdrant for searching. So this is what we do right here. In step 8, we start searching and retrieving the documents. Basically, we set a timer here to know how much time this process actually took. And here we also enable rescoring and oversampling so we can improve the accuracy of our search. So if we weren't using these techniques, our search process would actually be a little bit faster. So we're setting the limit here to 10. So I want to retrieve 10 documents that match my query. And then we can see that this search completed in 0.81 seconds. This is actually almost twice as fast as this same method with scalar quantization. And the great news here is that the first image that we got, which is basically the most accurate image to match our search query, is the same image that the original blog post by Daniel retrieved using scalar quantization. This is very significant, meaning that using binary quantization can also give you as good results than using scalar for models like ColPali, and can actually speed up your search time by 2 times as much for what we've seen so far. We can also see that other documents are very similar to what he got in the blog post, meaning that our accuracy is really not that bad. You can also use this notebook to test with your own dataset and actually evaluate how the model behaves with different types of settings. Remember, it's very important to test on your own data, and this was only a fun experiment that we made with this UFO dataset. That's it. It's really that simple to get started with ColPali, and this is one of the most promising strategies for document retrieval that can change the way we do things from now on. Are you already building with ColPali or want to build in the future? Let us know in the comments below your plans, and also if you want to stay on top of more new vector search topics like this one, join our vector search community on Discord. The link is in the description. Also, YouTube seems to think that you might like to see this video up next, so you might want to check it out. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.